upgrading your fuel system is really part and parcel of modifying your car when you're trying to make more power. More power simply requires more fuel. But actually modifying that fuel system, getting larger pumps into the car, can be challenging. We're here with Kevin from Frenchy's Performance Garage to talk about some options that they've created for the Nissan platform. So for a start, Kevin, talk about the problem that you were trying to solve when you were coming up with your solutions.
Right, hey Andre. A lot of problems we found with the GTRs especially is the surging issues, the mounting issues, especially when you're going multi-pump setups. You just need more hardware in the same tight spot. Pairing those pumps, so bulkhead terminals, the number of wires required, the volume. It was just so many things we wanted to address, and we thought, let's design one compact solution that just ticks all those boxes.
Let's actually reverse up, because back when I ran my own shop, R32, 33 and 34 GTRs were pretty common for modification. They weren't as expensive as they are today. And, you know, we were maybe shoehorning an 044 Bosch pump into the factory hangar. And let's be honest, it wasn't pretty, but we were all doing it. These days, the requirements for fuel flow have increased. Why is that?
Horsepower demand and the type of fuel. So with ethanol, as you'd know, you need at least 30% more volume for a given output. And the outputs have grown significantly. I mean, remember 15 years ago when your 400 horsepower car was a winner, and now it's not even a running tune type thing, you know? So,
I mean, here in Sydney in particular, if you aren't sort of packing at least 1500 wheel horsepower, you might as well just leave the car in the garage, right?
Well, exactly. And in the roll racing scene, you don't even attempt anything if you don't have four digits. So that's been a driver, but also the main driver I've noticed over the years is the shift in clientele requirement. People want nice setups. They don't want zip tight pumps in the tank. They don't want cheap necessarily. They want high-end street cars. They want legal options to some extent. I mean, if anything, a lot of our New Zealand customers are asking for in-tank stuff, because for compliance, they can't have anything sort of in the boot that isn't enclosed. So
we also need to consider that these cars, you know, 15 years ago, you could pick up an R32 GTR for probably in the mid to high 20s, you know, $20,000 I'm talking about, New Zealand or Aussie dollars, was just talk for example, and now a good example is probably more like 100,000+. So we're talking about an expensive car, so sort of, let's be honest, half-assed modifications aren't going to cut it. You'd be devaluing the car, correct?
Exactly. And then 10, 15 years ago, we just didn't see the budgets. When you said to someone, oh, well, this is the best option for you, and they look at you and look at the price and go, well, no, that's not even in the brief. Whereas now, if anything, the budget isn't even part of the question. People are building $200,000-$300,000 cars, and the quality, the reliability, and having those systems that work is just the main driver. The budget just seems to be coming second these days. So massive shift in demographics, massive shift in just demand from customers, 100%.
Okay, let's talk about a few of the features. So your billet solution here has a built-in surge tank as well, and the ability to run multiple pumps. Talk us through those aspects.
Yes, so as you know, surge tanks are a great thing. They've been in motorsport for a long time and for very good reasons. In-tank, obviously OEM situations and all that have been there as well. And I just thought, why not do both? I mean, people want surge tank operation, they just don't want surge tank mess or the layout or the smell or the heat. So I guess the biggest driver has been high performance street cars. People want race cars with number plates. That's just...
Let's talk about the problem here is that the factory fuel pump or fuel tank to a degree has some anti-surge built in, but that's fine for a street car. When you start particularly taking it to track days, that's not necessarily going to cut it. We all have had problems where we get down to half a tank of fuel and all of a sudden we're surging around a left-hand corner, for example, or whatever that may be. So the surge tank solution has traditionally been to put an external surge tank mounted in the boot. As you mentioned, there's problems around that. It's complex, it's messy. Sometimes you can end up with the fuel smell in the cabin, and then there's the legality as well. So you're now incorporating that surge tank in tank.
100%. So you nailed it. I mean, all these aspects is what we're trying to address. The 32 GTR tank is terrible in design. It's a big cube. So the moment you're half a tank, you actually have this big mass of fuel that just sloshes around and you don't have that much of a depth to it. So having a lift pump that scavenges your pump, your tank all the time, fills up a smaller pot that houses your main pumps, just gets rid of the air, gets rid of the waves. We've gone with a cylinder design because it gives you that full enclosure type setup. Just works really well, you know, it keeps everything just operating properly. And best of all, yeah, you get really good heat dissipation compared to an external one. You don't get that heat soak. Yeah,
let's talk about the options you've got for the pump. So obviously you've got that lift pump that actually draws the fuel out of the fuel tank and fills up this internal cylindrical surge tank. And you've got options for multi-pumps in there or a single pump, depending on the power requirements. What sort of pumps is it compatible with?
All right, so the bracketry inside is designed to house up to two main pumps, so your lift pump plus two. We worked around the 39 millimeter bodies because that's the bulk of your pumps out there, all your wall bros, all your AEMs, your race works, any of the, most of them are 39 mil. So that's what we decided to do. Two pumps, because 2525s in reality on E85, you'll get you 1,000 horsepower. In terms of streetcar terms, that's 90% of the people out there that will keep. So we can make triples, we can make different setups. We have customers that put brushless pumps in there to try and get that extra bit. That's all possible in there. We've made it very versatile unit.
Okay, the other problem when you're dealing with a factory pump hanger is basically adapting to the rest of your fuel system. What I'm talking about here is the fuel lines running from the tank forward to the engine bay. So, you know, when we're starting to talk about 1,000 plus horsepower, the factory fuel lines aren't going to cut it. Everyone's going with AN lines and fittings. So how do you adapt to that with your setup?
Exactly. So the billet head itself's got female threads. We went with an M18 thread because it's a Bosch A44 inlet. Very common size. There's an array of fittings available off the shelf, and that allowed us to offer from the barb to a dash 12 if you wanted to, and anything in between. The beauty is you can buy it once and upgrade it later. You might run a single pump with factory fuel lines, but in 6 months' time, you go twin pump with dash 8. Done.
So it can basically expand and grow with you. Let's talk about the wiring as well. This is another problem, getting enough current capability through to these pumps. Obviously, the factory pump is not drawing as much current as some of these aftermarket motorsport pumps. Then you get to a situation where you've now got three pumps. It's obviously going to be drawing a lot more current. We don't want to be melting wiring. That's obviously a recipe for disaster with a fuel system. So how do you deal with getting the wiring through?
100%. So the wiring is a big part of it. Commonly, we've seen a lot of problems even with people installing it. We've use the DTP connectors. I mean, Deutsch connectors have been in motorsport for a long time. They're the weapon of choice, and for very good reasons. They're just such a good connector. So this is what we went with. DTP's 25 amp pins, very easy to work with. It carries all the power you need. And what we've done with the hat is we've got four pins, which can do two positives, two negatives, but also you can actually do four positives and ground it through the hat. We've actually made a grounding point through the billet. If you look closely to the hat, you'll see anodizing has been removed in two spots, allowing you to convert your billet into a big grounding point. And it gives you so many options to stage pumps and power anything and everything.
You've got a lot of flexibility in there. Now, if people are interested in reaching out, finding out more about the product or purchasing, how they're best to do so?
100%. We've got a decent presence online, whether it's social media, Facebook, Instagram, under Frenchy's Performance Garage, YouTube videos, or the website itself, which is frenchysperformancegarage.com. Easy.
Perfect. Thanks for your time, Kevin. Great product, great solution to something that can be a little bit tricky to solve. Cheers for your time.
Awesome. Thank you, Andre.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.